Welcome back to the Magic Room, and blessings. We've returned to this place to continue our study of the Rider-Waite Tarot, one card at a time. Once again, we'll be investigating the imagery and symbolism to inform our own interpretations of the cards. Today, we'll be looking at the card numbered at 14 in the Major Arcana, Temperance. As ever, we'll begin with Waite's own brief divinations. Economy, moderation, frugality, management, and accommodation. The Tarot of Marseille and other earlier cards show a winged figure pouring liquid from one cup to another. According to Waite, the first thing which seems clear on the surface is that the symbol has no special connection with temperance, making the image a very obvious instance of a meaning behind a meaning. The Rider-Waite card shares this central image, but Waite and Smith have developed the card with some additional imagery. The figure itself is said to be of no gender, with Waite saying, although some regard this angel as feminine, it is neither female nor male. A common allegory for temperance in European iconography was an angel pouring water into wine in order to dilute it. However, Waite says of his card that the figure is held to be pouring the essences of life from chalice to chalice, going on to say, it has one foot upon the earth and one upon water, so illustrating the nature of the essences. In the tarot, earth is represented by the suit of pentacles and is considered to be the physical and tangible world that we inhabit. Water is represented by the suit of cups and is said to symbolize the emotional experience of life. This card can be thought of as the state of equilibrium between these two aspects of humanity. The card is rich in symbolism, with the angel displaying symbols upon its head and chest. According to Waite, it is a winged angel with the sign of the sun upon its forehead and on its breast the square and triangle of the septenary. The circled dot upon the head represents the sun, also gold in alchemy, and is the sign for Keter, the highest sephira on the Kabbalistic tree of life. The septenary symbol on the chest refers to the teachings of Helena Blavatsky, who presented a synthesis of Eastern and Western beliefs in her 1889 book, The Key to Theosophy. This further supports the notion of equilibrium presented by this card. Above this symbol, we once again find the tetragrammaton, the Hebrew word of God. In the distance, we see a pathway leading between two mountains and a bright light shining. Many consider this to be the passage of attainment for an ultimate goal. According to Waite, a direct path goes up to certain heights on the verge of the horizon, and above there is a great light through which a crown is seen vaguely. Here is some part of the secret of eternal life, as it is possible to a man in his incarnation. The card is often taken as a symbol of the need for moderation in our lives and can be a reminder to keep ourselves balanced and patient. Should we require a meaning of the card reversed, Waite provides us with a slightly more in-depth collection of divinations than usual. Things connected with churches, religions, sects, the priesthood, also disunion, unfortunate combinations, and competing interests. The card is the 14th to be met by the Fool along his journey, and is said to be the time when he discovers the concept of balance in his life. Temperance teaches the Fool that in order to truly progress, he must bring the elements of the previous cards together to form a harmonious perspective. The appearance of temperance is sometimes read as a symbol of the importance of keeping a level head when things appear to be out of control, and can remind us to stay calm and focused. Certainly, the themes of contemplation and tranquility are richly apparent in this, the card numbered at 14 in the tarot deck. Thank you so much for joining us in the Magic Room. May the coming days bring you peace, equilibrium, and harmony. Until next time.